Now I have another drama performance. We had some comments that the previous drama performance wasn't very clear, the idea of it. The idea is that in grade 10, our current unit in drama is character voices, and so each of us have had to write 3 scripts. One can be an existing script, and 2 have to be creative scripts. And we created a voice, and we performed them. So our next performers are going to be Sami Muhammad, Sami Medari, and Kisir Tom.
Och, Ulbert, um Gottes Willen, what is the mess you have created? Hydrochloric acid next to the boron of a reactor? I'm telling you, I'm never doing this drunk science again. I knew fortune cookies were, excuse my French, Schweinestall voller Vögelkotz. Get drunk and experiment around? What type of scientist actually does that?
Scholars debate the beginnings of a vodka and its a problematic and contentious issue due to the little historical material available on the subject of the origins of the vodka. According to some sources, the first production of the vodka took place in the area of today's Russia in the late 9th century. According to the Gin and Vodka Association, the first distillery was documented over 200 years later, that the Czechoslovak is reported in the Vatican Chronicle in the 1747. For many centuries, beverage differed significantly compared to the vodka of today, as the spirit in the time had different flavor, color, and smell, and was originally used as a medicine. The still allowing for distillation, the burning of wine, was invented in the 8th century. This, my friends, is the history of the vodka. It all started in Mother Russia.
Crikey, look over there. It's the Australian king cobra. Over 13 feet long, it has enough venom to kill 86 men. Let's throw rocks at it. Crikey, it's angry. This time, let's wrestle it. Alright, as you can see, its fangs are 13 inches long, and if I were to put my finger right there and it bites, I would instantly die.
You ain't messing with my man. You in my hood, respect my people. And you should probably get your little ugly hands off my man. Oh, hell no. You did not just raise your voice at me. Do you even know who you're talking to? Well, hello, this is Shaniqua, big mama's this hood. You, ma'am, are not supposed to be here. See those girls behind me? Those my crew. We eat, we talk, we walk, and do everything together. Now look at yourself, ma'am. Are you part of them? I guess so. Now out of my way, sister, out of this hood. That's right, keep on walking.
Hello, merhaba, selam aleykum, Chile Osman, Ice Capulet, what is going on? What is it, man? Wingers? Semani Wingers? La hua man fash, and what do we like here on the Toyota? La ya zandem ma man fash, I see, tkellem the manager, انت فاكر لو تكلم المنجر تاكل وينجز يا بنت الحرام السلام عليكم ازاي بيكلمني بالطريقه دي الوحشه دي انا محمد حماد عبد الصحاب في رمضان اكبر رجال مصر انا عايز اكلم مامتي بص انا هاخد شلت افل من المحل ده واكلم مامتي السلام عليكم
Being a lumberjack isn't what it's cut out to be, actually, quite really it is. We just cut down trees and the occasional Abercrombie and Fitch photographer. So that's why after a hard day's work, I enjoy a Sergeant Morgan's margarita. Wait, cut! Are you sure that this is the target audience that we're getting across to? I mean, what British lumberjack drinks margaritas? Plus, this is an obvious knockoff of Captain Morgan's, right? You do realize that that is not even a margarita.